Tonight, an intriguing matchup between the Nashville Sounds and the Louisville Bats. It's Baseball on the Show, and it's coming up next. Jeff Hoffman, a right-hander from the Empire State, gets the starting assignment here. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
This guy has three pitches that he brings into his mix. And if he has all of them working, he has a chance to be really solid. A good pitcher, but he needs command of all three of his pitches.
And stepping in, Troy Stokes. And we are set for baseball here this evening.
The left fielder, Troy Stokes.
Here's the pitch.
Junior.
Up and away to start the inning. It's 1-0.
First pitch, 7 o'clock.
And back-to-back pitches out of the zone to begin the evening. It's 2-0 now. And our game time temperature this evening, a nice 74 degrees. And a good comeback fastball there. It's two balls and a strike.
One of my pet peeves in the game. 1-0, 2-0, 3-1. You're all over the heater. How are you late on that fastball?
2-2 pitch is fouled away. Boyle's another one, and this is exactly what you're looking for out of your leadoff hitter. Now another 2-2. Tried to fool him with the changeup, but he won't offer at it. 3-2.
Gotta love the battle we're seeing right out of the gates in this game. That's seven pitches now, and if this is any indication, we're in for a good contest here.
And he can only battle for so long as he's finally set down here after an eight-pitch at-bat.
One thing to know is not all strikeouts are created equal. Right there, he goes down on strikes, but he really made that guy on the mound work for it. And when you're doing that in the first inning, it can have an effect on how deep he's going to be able to go into this start. There's a big difference between that and going down on three or four pitches.
One ball, no strikes to count. Bases are empty, one man out. Inside corner, a ball and a strike. Mathias, certainly a versatile middle infielder, playing shortstop today despite being a second baseman naturally.
Yeah, Matty, normally the transition from second base to shortstop goes the other way around, but this guy has such a strong arm, I don't see it being any problem for him to put his foot in the ground, backhand something in that 5-6 hole, and throw a strike to first base.
The 2-2 is in there, a called strike three.
The main job of the number one and two hitters is to set the middle of the order up with an opportunity to do some damage. So when you strike both of them out, you're putting yourself in a pretty good position to make it through the teeth of the lineup without a whole lot of stress.
Daniel Vogelbach's next. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. Two outs already on the K this inning, so he'll be looking to do better. Now the 1-0 is offered at and missed for the first strike.
Hey, I know it's early and we're in the first right here, but he's going to have to work that heater to both sides of the plate. He cannot get away with missing over the heart of the plate all night.
Two out, nobody on. Into the corner and slicing foul. Here now the 2-2. Drilled right back up the middle. And that finds its way through for a base hit.
Nice AB right there. A little potential for some two-out lightning. Getting a cleanup hitter to the dish after the first two batters of the inning were retired.
Derek Fisher the next to bat as he'll take a look at ball one. He takes his first cuts in this one with a man at first and two away. And a strike to even the count. One and one. Vogelback leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. And he leads off the breaking ball there as he moves ahead to 2-1. To 2-2 now. Left side, but well foul. The 2-2 one more time.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way, and it's fouled away. He'll try it again, 3-2. Did well just to make contact there as he spoils off a good changeup. He loses him on ball four.
Oh, man, I think this walk is going to grind at him for a bit. He just missed, and now the inning continues with the man in scoring position.
Shaw.
Two men on, two out, and that brings up the left-handed hitter Travis Shaw. Wheels and deals, here's the first pitch.
Perfect time for a mound visit right here. Just give him a breather, a chance to collect himself and get back to work.
Two down, runners at first and second. Ball and a strike. Count moves to a ball and two strikes now. To two balls and two strikes now.
Now 2-2, two on, two out. This is when you have to make a pitch right here. The last thing you want to do is run the count full to 3-2. Then the runners are going to be off to the races.
Two and two. Here it is. A swing and a miss on a ball way outside the strike zone, and the inning is over. No runs, a hit, two left. So it's on to the bottom of inning number one. No score. Josh Lindblom, the right-hander out of Indiana, will be doing the pitching in this one. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
Well, this guy's kind of unique. How about a five-pitch repertoire that he has? That gives him a lot of options for both righties and lefties. And if he's on, he could be really tough to hit.
And now here is Nick Senzel. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. From the stretch, ball one. The 1-0 delivery. Swing and a little blooper to center. Mathias onto the grass. He gets to it and makes the catch for the first out.
Batting second.
And with that, here's a glance at the starting lineup for the home squad. Mark, what do you have on this group in front of the home crowd tonight?
Matty, I love the way this lineup's constructed. Talking to the manager before the game, he focused on the fact that they have a pass the baton mentality. everything's flowing for this lineup, chance to score a lot of runs.
Into the box now, number 28, as he'll swing and miss at a first pitch slider at strike one. The 0-1 pitch. That's taken. Now it's 0-2. And a fastball swung on and missed as he just reared back there, two away.
Boy, that's the best pitch in baseball right there with two strikes, that elevated fastball. Every hitter thinks that, hey, they can do something with that, but most of the time, you get the result that you saw right there, a big swing and a miss and another strikeout.
At the plate, Logan Morrison. As with two away, he'll swing and miss at the first pitch. It's 0-1. First cuts for him here with the bases open and two away. Ready with the nothing and one pitch.
1-1.
Bases are empty here with two men out. He's fallen behind now, 3-1. Max Schrock would be next if they can keep this inning alive. Here's the 3-1. Grounded down the third baseline, and this will stay inside the third base bag. A fair ball. And he'll make it to second base now with two gone.
He just smoked this ball right down the line. Take a look here. Hard to tell if it was fair or foul in real time, but you can see it flies right over the bag. Ump was all over it and made a great call.
Standing in now, Max Schrock. And a swing from him yields a foul pop out of play to the right. Runner in scoring position with two gone. And he gets around on one and hits it high and deep to straightaway right. And it's gone. Two-run blast to straightaway right field as it's now a 2-0 ball game.
What a way to start this one off. Scoreless top of the frame, and you answer with a bomb in the bottom of the first.
That is good.
Malik Smith the next to hit. And on the first pitch, he grounds foul. Looking to get on base and keep this first inning alive. Swing and a miss, and he's in control, 0-2.
Down 0-2, maybe simplify the game plan right here. Get on the heater, even though he has five weapons to go to.
Too high. 1-2. In tight with the slider, 2-2.
The classic back foot slider right there with two strikes. Usually gets a ton of swing and misses. Nice layoff right there. Fight for another pitch.
Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble. Around first, he's digging for second. And now he'll get into scoring position with two away.
When he started this game, giving up three extra base hits in the opening frame was not what he had in mind. He could still settle down and turn things around on the mound, but the way it's going right now, this has the makings of a start he's going to want to forget.
To the plate now, Rhys Hines, as he'll take a look at a slider here that misses for ball one. Opportunity for him here to pick up that runner from second with two away. Count even now at 1-1. Good lead there at second. Here's the pitch.
One ball, two strikes, man.
Misses ball two.
We just saw a fastball right there. I would not be shocked if he tries to get this guy to go fishing right here and drops a little off-speed pitch in the dirt.
Won't commit on the slider. Good patience, and it's full 3-2.
Some pitchers fall into the trap of giving in on 3-2 because they don't want to walk the guy. But with the base open, it's not the end of the world if you do. You still need to make a quality pitch.
And that misses ball four, so it's first and second now with two out.
Wow, he's looking awfully shaky to start this game, guys. That's three hits and a walk. And there's no doubt that he's fighting himself right now. See if he can get this train back on the rails here.
Now at the plate is Bo Taylor. Another first inning RBI opportunity for him here. Looking to minimize the damage here. Swung on but fouled off to the left.
After the walk and with runners on the bags, he couldn't afford to fall behind here. Nice job of jumping ahead with strike one.
Smith over at second, Hines at first, two out in the inning. And this one's in the dirt. Good job to get to that quickly, though, and the count will even at one. No contact there, and it's 1-2. Ball two. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. Here now, the 2-2. Is a swing and a miss. That's strike three. But two come across to score in the inning courtesy of this two-run home run. We'll head to the top of the second. It's now a 2-0 ball game. Into the box, Keston Hiura. Lifetime against this pitcher. Just a couple of matchups, no hits in two at-bats.
Hiura.
First offering on its way. Swing and a miss, but he's right on here. One strike. Fastball, and he's quickly in the hole, 0-2. Nothing in two count, and the pitch. Popped high in the air. And there's out number one.
Batting seven.
All right, here's how the home side's lining up defensively. And let's take a look at outfielder Malik Smith. Speed is his game, period, the end. He is up at the plate. He is trying to put that defense and infield on their toes. And from a defensive standpoint, nobody goes to their right or left as quick as this guy.
In now, Corey Ray. As the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1.
A 3-1 count, tying run on deck. Good spot to be a hitter right now. You have to look for something middle in.
Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. Opposite field to left. Smith is right there as he'll put it away without much problem for the second out.
Well, this one was squared up pretty good, but just like pitchers give up hits on well-executed pitches, batters make outs on balls they couldn't have hit much better.
Into the box, number 12. As the first pitch to him is taken low and away for ball one, he'll work on keeping this top of the second alive. The 1-0 home.
2-0.
I like the way they're making him work out on that mound. They've taken a lot of early pitches right here. It's going to benefit them in the later innings.
Too tight with that one. 3-0.
He's really going to need to keep the walks down in this start. He's in danger of walking the second guy in two innings here.
3-1.
Down to 3-1.
The 3-1. And he misses here for ball four. Already two walks surrendered in his first couple of innings of work.
That walk is going to feel a little extra frustrating for this pitcher. Not only do you never really want to walk the number eight hitter, but it's also going to let the pitcher hit this inning instead of forcing him to lead off the next one.
He's set and the pitch. Josh Lindblom is in with two away as he takes a ball 1-0. Big swing and a miss at the changeup, a ball and a strike. Now a fastball gets the upper part of the zone for strike two. This is foul right side.
He's certainly pushing the throttle and pulling it with those four pitches. Statistics class tells me I'm sitting fast.
2-0. Above the letters with the fastball that time.
You certainly know he's not trying to work around the pitcher, but sometimes the hardest thing to do is to throw a strike to a guy that you know won't swing the bat.
Now a swing and a fly ball, but this is going to wind up a foul ball. Seventh pitch of the at-bat coming up. This one misses, and that'll fill the count here. 3-2 with two away.
These are the kind of ABs, regardless of the outcome, you go back to the dugout as an offensive player, and your teammates are loving on you for making that pitcher work and battling it out.
Now he tries to hold back on the swing, and the home plate umpire says he did so successfully. It's ball four.
And you can tell by his body language that he's beyond frustrated by that call. He's got to be wondering what he's got to do, but the last thing he needs to do is to let it get under his skin. That will only make things worse.
First pitch of the AB now. Troy Stokes is in for his second plate appearance as he looks at a ball. It's 1-0.
Something's clearly out of sorts with his delivery right now. Just walked the guy, and that pitch wasn't even within snipping distance of the zone. Really fighting himself right now.
Two-0 count, the pitch.
Two on, two out with the base open here. As a pitcher, you have to be awful careful. You just don't want to groove something here and give this guy a pitch that he can hit one out of the park on.
Here it is, the 3-0.
Three and one with two on, and this is where you got to be geared up for something to drive. I don't think you can just groove him one right here. You still have to try to make a competitive pitch.
As a look, now the pitch. And that misses. Ball four, and he's going to need to settle down in a hurry now because he's in a peck of trouble.
I think he was trying to be a little too fine there, and a walk is the result. Well, the good news is he has a force at every base. The bad news, a single probably drives in a couple of runs.
Striding in is Mark Mathias. A base knock to the outfield could score the tying run from second. Trying to hang a zero. Here's the pitch.
Clearly, this is a tough situation to be on the mound, but the key here is minimizing. They're up by two, so if he could find a way to get out of this bases loaded jam by only giving up one run, that would be clutch.
Can't get around quick enough, and that'll move the count to 1-1.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
And he fouls this one off.
I mean, he's coming right after him, Matty. Three fastballs in a row.
Lindblom at second. Stokes on at first with two down. A curveball hit right back at him. And they get the force at home. Whatever works as the side is retired. So no runs in the inning despite three walks as they couldn't make them pay. On now to the bottom of the second. Louisville's out in front here, 2-0. Stepping up is Alfredo Rodriguez. He's set to lead off the home half of the second.
For me, this is an important add-on inning here. Their little lead is cute. I like it, but keeping the pressure on, building that lead. That's how you bury someone.
But this is gloved over there at first as he was in the right spot at the right time. One away.
Okay, here's a defense for the away team. And let's take a look at Travis Shaw. The calling card's the bat. Left-handed power, the ability to manipulate both gaps, but also a very adequate, very underrated defender on both corners, both first and third.
Into the box now, Jeff Hoffman. Ball one. Swing and a liner. And the pitcher's got himself a base hit.
You think there's any justice in the game? Watch those two at bats. Both of them hit on the absolute zoom. One's right at one guy, and then one's a single. Go figure.
So now to the plate, Nick Senzel. As he'll take a look at a pitch too low, it's ball one. Flied out in his first at bat, so make him 0-for-1 so far. fouled off. Fouled off again, and now he's in a 1-2 hole. From the stretch, here's a fly ball well hit. Ranging back is Ray, and this will get all the way to the wall now. Hoffman blows through the stop sign, headed for home. Safe at the plate as they push their lead to 3 now.
Hey guys, that's a well-executed slider down and away right there. The batter just did an amazing job of staying inside the baseball and driving it the other way.
Standing in now, number 28. Down the line and fair, that's a hit. And that'll bring home another as they open it up to a 4-0 advantage now. The relay throw, and he is in there with an RBI triple. Well, Dan, do you agree with the timing of the visit from the pitching coach?
You know, that's sort of a tough one since it's only the second inning, but I think it's about knowing your pitcher and how they respond. He's had some struggles here, so I think he's just reminding him to let those go and focus on the next batter.
Stepping in now, Logan Morrison, as he looks at a fastball that misses off the plate for ball one. 1-for-1 as he reached base with a double his first time up. The 1-0 home.
2-0 to a guy with this kind of pop, you better be awfully careful because he's going to be swinging out of his shoes.
Three and oh now.
Great game plan so far by this offense. They're not chasing any of those breaking balls out of the zone.
Now Lomo turns on one and sends it to deep right field. Ray looks up, and this ball is gone. No chance to make a play on that one. A two-run blast to straightaway right field as they pile on. It's now 6-0.
That wasn't the plan. You just have a meeting with your pitching coach to go over some strategy, and all of a sudden you throw one and it leaves the ballpark.
He's ready, and he'll take the ball from the manager.
The right fielder, number 32. Max Schrock.
In now, Max Schrock, as he'll take a look at a high strike that time. It's nothing and one. He launched one over the wall back in the opening frame. Oh, 1, here's the pitch. And he'll look at a fastball just off the black, and it's even at 1. Four runs here in this half inning. Fouled away. Three fastball. Strike three called as he couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away.
Well, that call looked like it was a little in the pitcher's favor, but it wasn't outrageous. Hey, listen, calling balls and strikes is a really tough job, and even the best are going to miss some from time to time, especially when they're sort of borderline like that last one. Not sure the hitter would want to hear that, though.
So here's Malik Smith. Strike one to start the at-bat. It was a double for him in his first turn at the plate. Sinker, one ball, one strike.
One and one.
The 1-1 home. Hit out towards second. Fielded cleanly. Throw in time, and they stop the bleeding as the side is retired. So they score four times on four hits, no errors, and no one left on base. We play two full. The Bats lead it 6-0. Now to the plate. Here is Daniel Vogelbach. And D-Row down six already in the early part of this ball game. What's the mentality for them as they try to work their way back?
You know what, Matty? This is where you take some prideful ABs. I've been down six before, and I've come back from even further down than that in some big ball games. You have to find a way to just relax and start piecing some good ABs back to back.
First offering. Now a fastball a bit too low here. It's ball one. And now we'll see some action in the bullpen as the lefty starts to get loose. And here's a fastball that's nowhere near the zone. It's 2-0 now. And it's fouled away. Now the 2-1. Is it very well to right? This one's hammered, and it's going to go. That one is gone. A solo shot here to straightaway right field, and they're on the board. It's 6-1.
Yeah, they dug themselves quite a hole, but they say the first thing you need to do when that happens is to stop digging. Well, with that solo shot, they've stopped digging, but they've got a long way to go before they climb out of this hole completely.
At the plate, Derek Fisher. As the first pitch to him is swung on and missed for strike one. Worked a walk in his first plate appearance. Here's the 0-1.
He's attacking this hitter a lot more aggressively than he did the first time when he faced him and issued a walk, coming right after him here.
Nothing in two count, and the pitch. Now a swing and a miss as he picks up another one. Make it four strikeouts already, and there's your first out.
Looked to me like he had the right idea with the swing on that pitch, and he just didn't get the bat through the zone in time. The pitch was away. He let it get deep, maybe trying to take it the other way, but it got too deep and was by him by the time his barrel could get in the correct position.
And that brings up the left-handed hitting Travis Shaw. He swings and hits it foul off to the right and out of play. Struck out in his first at-bat. The 0-1 on its way. Swing and a miss as he pulls the top hand over. It's 0-2.
0-2 count. You could do just about anything you want right now. Up, down, in, out, hard, soft. Good time to be a pitcher.
Looking to punch him out again. The pitch. And there's a fastball well off the plate inside.
Love the high heater right there to raise the hitter's sights. Let's see if he buries something in the dirt right here.
The 1-2.
I'll tell you right now, he let go of that one and he wanted to pull it back. That was a hanger, bad spot over the heart of the plate. He's lucky. He's lucky that's getting sent back to him.
Still 1-2 as he fouls it away. Making him sweat out there. The seventh pitch coming up. Tough one to call there, but it's ruled just above the zone.
We've got ourselves an awesome battle going on right here. Bottom line, the guy who's going to win this situation is the guy who executes.
Changes up on him, but that's in the dirt for the ball.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
On the run is Smith. And now this will be the 10th pitch of the at-bat. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. Once again, a 3-2. Another one sent foul.
I didn't realize the pitcher and the hitter were being so charitable today, giving away 7 free souvenirs to the fans. This is one of those epic at-bats. Everyone wins.
Fastball too low, and that's ball 4.
I know one thing. He earned that free pass right there. He was tempted with some really good pitches, but he stayed disciplined and drew the walk.
Cionel Pérez is going to come on to pitch here, and in just the third inning, you have to think he'll be asked to eat some innings. Keston Hiura will be the first to greet him here as he'll stand in with a runner at first and one away. From the belt, kicks and deals.
Ball, that's it.
Well below the knees, laid off on the changeup there.
Well, both of those balls have been inside, so if I'm hitting, I'm looking for something I could get my arms extended on. Probably won't come back inside for a third time.
Now the 2-0 home is swung on and missed, strike one.
Hey, as a hitter, you got to tip your hat right there. 2-0, you're sitting all over a piece of cheese, and he pulls the string right there. Let's see if the batter makes an adjustment and sits changeup right here.
Count even at 2-2. Swing and a miss on the fastball that time, out number 2.
Boy, there's nothing like seeing a good power pitcher that has a good fastball. And what does he do? He just throws this good fastball right by, brings the express. No chance to put that ball in play.
To the plate now, Corey Ray, as he'll take one up in the zone, but indeed in the strike zone for the first strike. 0-for-1 here in the early going. Oh. pitch is mishandled behind the plate, and it bounces away. And he'll make it to second here as he's moved into scoring position now after the passed ball.
And this is why you can't lose focus for a second when you're behind the plate. Any mistake a catcher makes has serious consequences. This is a pass ball, and the runner moves into scoring position.
Changeup just off the black, and it's 2-1.
Interesting sequence of pitches right there. A real ugly swing on a ball away, and it looks like the batter has a much better idea of what he's looking for after that second pitch.
Shaw at second with two down. Nope. 3-1 now. And the count will be full. And he fouls this one off. Ready with the payoff pitch. And that misses ball four. So it's first and second now with two out.
Now batting, number 12.
And now number 12. Two on, two out for him here in the third. Now the first pitch.
Ball, that's up there.
Two men are on with two men out. Fastball, and that thing got up there at 95 miles an hour, a ball and a strike. The 1-1 gets him out in front on a good changeup. And a good take there. Close, but it's 2-2. Lifts it into the air to shallow center. Senzel makes the play, and the side is retired. But a solo home run will at least get this closer to respectability. We play 2.5. Louisville's out in front here, 6-1. Now it'll be Reese Hines. He'll get us going in the home half of inning number 3. And now the first pitch. Too much dip on the sinker, laid off for a ball. And a strike to even the count. 1-1.
Not the ideal location for a changeup up in the zone, but he got away with it.
Now the 1-1 pitch. Misses inside off the plate. Out in front there as this one's pulled off to the left side. Here now the 2-2. He is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
Well, I'm glad we get another look at that beauty of a pitch right there. You can't spot a sinker in a better location because even if you do get the bat on the ball, there's not a whole lot you could do with that. Textbook sinker.
Man. At the plate now, Bo Taylor, as he'll go after the first pitch and bounce it into foul territory. 0 for 1 for him here in this one. Nothing in one count. Here it comes. Speared on the dive. He gathers the throw in time.
Now batting.
Into the box, Alfredo Rodriguez, as he will look at a first pitch fastball for ball one. Hit it hard but lined out in his first at bat. The 1-0. Two out, nobody on. And he pumps the fastball by him here. 1-2 now.
Take a step back right here. After three fastballs in a row, there is no chance he throws you a fourth.
Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball. Well off the inside that time as the sinker misses for a ball. This should end the inning as it's sent out to second. Reined in. Throw to first beats him easily and the side is retired. So they breeze through this half of the inning. On now to the top of inning number four. The bats lead it 6-1. Digging in will be number 63. First trip to the plate for him in the ball game.
Number 63.
Now here's the pitch. First pitch hack in here, and that's the first strike. Here's a little chopper up the middle. He's got it. Throw to first in time. One gone here in the fourth.
Now batting, left fielder, Troy Stokes Jr.
Next to hit, Troy Stokes. It was a walk in his last trip. First offering on its way.
Well, that's not great.
One out, nobody on. Fastball laid off well below the knees. Pretty good cut there, but it's to 2-1 now.
That was a great hack right there. Timing was on point. Just sometimes you have bad bat barrel accuracy.
Throw on to first, two gone.
Now batting, the shortstop, Mark Mathias.
So next to hit is Mark Mathias. 0 for 2 from him so far in this one. First pitch coming. Here it is.
Hey, with two outs in the number two hole, you're just trying to get on. You got the big boys coming up behind you.
The 1-0. A swing and a miss. That's the first strike. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
You know he's probably cheating on that inside pitch after he got jammed earlier. If you're on the mound right now, you want to try to hit that outside corner, and there's a pretty good chance you'll get him to roll over something.
Oh, not cheated on that one. It's 2-2.
With the way this guy's throwing on the mound, you cannot be chasing. You have to set your sights a little bit lower and control the strike zone.
And no trouble for him as he makes the catch to end the inning. So now here is Cionel Pérez.
Leading off for the Bats, the pitcher, Cionel.
From the stretch, here's the pitch. And he swings through a fastball and doesn't catch up with it. It's 0-1.
Hey, if you're able to blow a first pitch fastball by a guy, gotta believe that pitch is coming again right here.
The 0-1 pitch. Now a changeup is bounced to second. Scooped up. Throw on to first in time, one away. And there's a final look at the numbers for the starter in this one. Not the night he or his club were hoping for.
Man, did this one get ugly early. As a starting pitcher, you're looking to get some length, and certainly 5 or 6 innings. He couldn't even get out of the second inning in this one. This is one he'd certainly like to forget.
The pitch. Nick Senzel stands in for the third time now as he takes a look at a ball. It's 1-0. Now here's the pitch. There's a swing and a ball lifted to left, but back in the seats, out of play. It's 1-2. And the pitch.
I got to count 2-2.
Line drive to left, and that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit.
No mistake what he was sitting on, looking for a dead red piece of cheese middle of the plate, and he didn't miss it.
Into the box now, number 28. Standing in from the right side as he takes strike one. Senzel, base runner at first with one out. And he lays off for ball one. And now a left-hander will start to get ready in the bullpen. He'll take a look at a strike on the inside corner. It's 1-2.
Hey, make no mistake about it. This lineup's going to have to get going and get a little bit more aggressive. This guy's pounding the zone.
Looked like the fastball got away from him there. It's ball two. Runners on first with one down. Now a throw over.
No, he's safe.
Here now the 2-2. Timing just to tick off there as this one's fouled off to the right. shot down the line. It's a fair ball. Senzel rounds the corner and is headed home. The tag, and he's safe. And it's now a six-run lead. So much of this game is situational hitting, guys. Nice job there.
Yeah, you've got to find a way to pick your teammates up when you're given the chance. And he doesn't try to do too much right here. He just takes what's there. Safely on second, and his buddy is high-fiving teammates in the dugout.
Stepping in now, Logan Morrison, as he will take strike one on the fastball here. No balls and a strike. A couple of RBIs for him already, and a chance for more here. Here comes the 0-1. One out and a runner on second base. Fastball just misses. That's ball one.
Stone cold take right there. That fastball very well could have sent him packing back to the bench.
The 1-2 is looked at for ball number two. The 2-2. Hit in the air to straightaway center. Fisher's under it. Two down.
The right fielder, number 32, Max.
Next, it'll be Max Schrock. Comes in 1-for-2 with that home run he hit earlier. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. And he holds up here, but the pitch is a cold strike anyway. And he takes this one high, 1-1. Runner in scoring position at second with two down. On the ground to third. Shaw fields it cleanly. Throw cleanly into first, and that ends the inning. It's a run on two hits, one left. On to the top of inning number five we go. Louisville's out in front here, 7-1. So now into the box is Daniel Vogelbach. He's got hits in both of his at-bats so far in this one.
Vogelbach.
Outfield shaded toward right center. Here's the first pitch. High and tight here to begin the inning. It's ball one. And that's in there for his strike, 1-1. One and two now as that one's fouled off.
Hey, last two pitches back-to-back off speed. Then he's late on the fastball. He could pretty much do anything he wants right here on the mound.
And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning.
Classic slider down and away for the strikeout there. Not a whole lot to say about that pitch that hasn't been said a million times already. That's just a real tough pitch for a hitter to pick up out of a pitcher's hand. So they end up chasing when they're in protect mode.
So now to the plate, Derek Fisher. As he looks at a fastball that's in there for strike one. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. And this misses the outside corner, so it's knotted up at 1-1. Fouled off. Oh, and he struck him out as well. So he's carving right through the heart of this lineup as there are two away now. Good job of making him chase a pitch for the strikeout there.
Yeah, Matt, that's the advantage of getting ahead in the count. You can really force hitters to expand their zone to protect. And when they're in that mode, getting them to go after a pitch they can't do much with becomes a lot easier.
So digging in next will be Travis Shaw. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. It was a walk in his last trip. Now the 1-0.
Now, when you've got a 6-run lead out there, there's no reason not to go right at guys. You have to keep attacking the zone.
The 2-0 on the way.
Nasty 2-0 slider right there for a strike. No shame in tipping your hat.
Bases are empty here with two men out. Lifted the other way down the left field line. Smith in pursuit, but this is just going to wind up being a foul ball. The 2-2.
Count is full, 3-2.
Fouled away.
It's going to be back to some serious tee work if he can't put that pitch in play right in his wheelhouse.
The next 3-2. Shaw connects. This is sent to deep right field. And that one is gone on a two-strike count with two away in the inning. A solo home run there for Travis Shaw, and it's a 7-2 game now.
Yeah, and if you remember the previous pitch, he couldn't get around on a fastball and was mad at himself. Well, there's nothing to be mad about anymore unless you're the guy standing on the mound wondering what just happened.
And that'll bring up Keston Hura as he'll try to hold back on the swing, but he went around for the first strike. 0-2 for him to this point. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. High in the air out to center field. He's under it, and that ends the inning. But not before they answer back here with a solo home run. On to the bottom of the fifth. The Bats lead it 7-2. Stepping in once again is Malik Smith. 1-for-2 with a double on his line thus far. Now the first pitch. Hit out towards second. And that is through into right field for a single.
Third baseman, number 3.
Standing in now, Reese Hines. As the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. He was sat down on strikes in his last at-bat. Now a fastball here, not close, and it's 1-1 now. And this one runs a little too far in, ball two. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball. Bo Taylor waits on deck. The 3-1. There goes Smith. Hit the other way out toward right field. Ray waits on it. And that's the first out of the inning.
Now batting, number 36.
Next to hit is Bo Taylor. Third trip to the plate for him here. He struck out and grounded out in his first two tries. From the belt, kicks and deals. And they pitch out here, but nothing's going on. In there, 1-1.
Can't come out of his game plan right here. He knows he's a known sinker baller. I know it was a four-seamer right there, but get back to that two-seam. It's what his MO is.
Smith, the runner at first with one gone in the inning. Throw over to the bag. A dive, but he's back. And he comes back with a fastball. 1-2 now. Pulled toward right center field. Fisher is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first.
Now batting, not shortstop.
So the next at bat will be Alfredo Rodriguez, grounded out in his last at bat. He comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. And that misses, ball one. Ball and a strike. A runner on first with two away. Outside, 2-1. From the belt, kicks and deals. Lined hard to center field. And that finds the outfield grass for a base hit. And he's in safely to third as a run will score on the play as well. Michael DeLeon will be charged with the job of getting that guy home as he'll pinch hit with two gone and a runner at third. Now here's the first offering.
At the ball. Hold on, no strike.
The 1-0 delivery. 2-0 now.
This inning really feels like it's getting away from him out there. As a reliever, you can't let that happen. Nothing you can do about what's already happened, and it's only going to get worse if you're not focusing on the guy in the batter's box.
Down low, and the plot thickens here, 3-0. Nick Senzel would be next if they can keep this inning alive. Here it comes, the 3-0. It is taken, strike one.
Stealing that strike on 3-0 was important, but you don't want to miss over the heart of the plate in this situation. I got to believe he's going to be way more aggressive right here.
Here, strike two as the slider hits the outside corner. He's set. Here's the 3-2. Hit out towards second. And that's through into center field. Base hit. And the runner scores from third as they extend their lead. Now a 9-2 ball game.
You know what I like right there, Dan, is the batter's approach. Not trying to do too much. Just taking it right back up the chute again. Staying within himself. And just knowing that anything to the outfield gets him an RBI.
Now that's a good piece of hitting. That's a great point, Dero. I think a lot of times hitters go up there trying to do a little bit too much. Sometimes you just have to go ahead and hit the ball where it's pitched, and a good job and a run batted in.
Number 36 is on, and he'll take over on the mound in relief. To the plate now, Nick Senzel. Yes, he'll look at a fastball in there on the outer half. It's 0-1. So far, 2-for-3 in this one. Ready with the 0-1. High in the air down the right field line. Ray gets under it and makes the catch to end the inning. So it's 2 runs on 3 hits, no errors, and a runner left on. We're through 5 here at the ballpark. Louisville's out in front here, 9-2. Carson Fulmer takes over to start the 6th inning on the mound. Now into the box, Corey Ray. It was a walk in his last trip. Corey Ray. First offering. On its way, the 0-1 pitch. This is line to left. That's his first base hit, making 1-for-2 now. So the leadoff man's aboard in their half of the 6th inning.
You got to be frustrated if you're on the mound. You try and go elevated heater right there and blow some cheese by him, and he's able to scramble it and drive it the other way for a base hit. Nice job by the hitter to get the barrel to that baseball.
At the plate now, number 12. Popped him up. Number 28 backs up a bit, and he takes charge for the first out.
That's exactly what they wanted out of that pitch up in the zone. They took him up the ladder, and he couldn't get up to it. So that was an easy pop-out. Well-executed pitch there.
Into the box now, number 36. And they'll try and play for one here as he gets this one down. Throw not in time at first, so the pitcher tries to give himself up, but instead he gets himself a base hit. At the plate, Troy Stokes. And he'll promptly send it in the air out to center field. Senzel is there now, and he has it. 2 gone.
The bat, number 13, shortstop, Mark Mathias.
Now at the plate, here is Mark Mathias. No hits in 3 tries so far. He's struck out once. Here's the first pitch.
Ball one.
From an offensive standpoint, this is where you got to push the throttle right here. You've had a couple hits in the inning. You got a 1-0 count leverage. Let's see if he can gap something.
That swung on and missed. We're even at 1-1. off-speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball.
He's got a couple of pitches to deal with right here, but he's starting to lose command of his pitches. It might be time to take a step back and try to refocus on making some good pitches.
Two down, runners at first and second. And it's fouled away. The 2-2.
Not a time to fool around right now on a 3-2 count with the middle part of the order coming up. Expect a good pitch to swing at.
Drilled on the ground is short. And the two-out threat won't pay off. The inning is over. So here is number 28. He bats here with a double and a triple on his line in this one.
The second baseman, number 28.
Now the pitch. Good changeup there to start him, but it drops a little low for ball one. Right-hander starts to loosen out in the bullpen now. And he watches one miss outside, 2-0 now.
Well, that's another great hitting count here on 2-0. It's no wonder why they're up 7.
The pitch.
Hey. Count 2-1. Inside
for a ball as he falls behind to him here, 3-1. Logan Morrison is on deck. And that one misses, so the leadoff man will head down to first on ball four to start the bottom of the sixth.
You know, it takes a lot of discipline to watch a pitch like that go by, but on a 3-1 count, he had the luxury of being a little bit more selective up there. Good take, and a walk is the result.
Next, here is Logan Morrison. He flew out in his last debut. First delivery to him.
Nope.
Pitch taken, several inches below the zone, in fact. That's by him for strike one.
One ball, one strike.
Hit high and deep to straightaway right field. Ranging back is Ray. On the warning track, he makes the catch.
Now batting the right fielder.
Stepping in next, Max Schrock. He bounced out last time up.
Yeah, Matty, expect this pitcher to try and get the same result as his last at bat right here. The double play is in order. Anything on the ground, the way this defense is, they could certainly roll too.
Lifted down the line in left. Left fielder coming in. He makes the running play. Two down.
Now batting, left fielder. Mallett. Smith.
Next to stand in is Malik Smith. He's 2-for-3 and looking for more here. First delivery to him. Here's the 0-1 pitch.
Ball.
Two out with the man at first. swing and a liner. But he will close fast out there in right field as he comes on to put it away, and the inning is over. So now to the plate, Daniel Vogelbach. He has no prior history against this pitcher.
Daniel Vogelbach.
He's set. Here it comes. Tried to check it, and it's 0-1. And he takes strike two. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. Vogelbach behind, ball and two strikes.
He didn't look overly fooled right there, because a lot of pitchers will go to the breaking stuff 0-2, but he certainly looked ready for a breaker on that pitch.
The 1-2 is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
Well, we've seen some really good pitching from these guys on this one. The bullpen has looked sharp and have backed up a nice effort turned in by the starter. These days, pitching has become a full staff effort, and I've been impressed with the job these guys have done so far.
In now, Derek Fisher. He swings and hits it foul off to the right and out of play. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. Here comes the 0-1. Bases are empty, one man out. And he fouls this one off. Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. Ball three. 3-2 now. Travis Shaw is on deck. Now the 3-2 pitch. High chopper to third. Fielded cleanly. On to first, and a good stretch over there is going to get him by a step for the second out.
Now that one. The third baseman, Travis Shaw.
Ready now is Travis Shaw. It was a solo shot for him in his last at bat.
Yeah, he absolutely torched a fastball his last time up. Pretty much a no doubter, so he's got to be feeling pretty confident right here.
Here's the first pitch. Now the fastball is swung on and missed.
It's not easy to get your barrel to a pitch that high. That could be an effective location as long as he keeps it above the letters.
Curveball close, but it's 1-1. Two out, nobody on. Fouled off. Ready with the 1-2. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. The next 1-2 pitch. Popped him up. Hines in foul ground. And that will end the inning. Nothing across here this half. We'll move on now to the bottom half of the seventh. Get up and stretch. The bats lead it 9-2. Now at the plate, Reese Hines. He's 0-2 in the ballgame so far.
The third baseman.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. And a changeup here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball. Now the 1-0. On he goes with the slider that time, and it's driven to deep right field. And that'll get down out there for extra bases. And he will coast into second with a leadoff double.
That was a great job of driving that ball, extending his arms very well, was able to get it over the right fielder's head, one hopping it off the wall for an easy double. That's one of those solid hits that you don't even feel coming off the bat.
So now to the plate, Bo Taylor, as he'll look at a fastball too high for ball one. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. And that swung on and missed on a pitch down, 1-1.
Swing and a miss on a nasty slider right there. Always felt toughest pitch in the game. If you're a guy who liked to work the big part of the field, you were on that fastball middle away. That slider looked like a heater for about 56 feet, 6 inches.
And the 2-1. Good fastball as he gets the swing and a miss. The 2-2 pitch swung on and missed, really fooled him that time for the first out. Next up is Alfredo Rodriguez, tripled homer run last time through, so we'll see what he's got in store here. Now the first pitch off the plate and away there, one ball, no strikes. And he falls behind now, 2-0.
I don't mind him trying to pitch him backwards right there with those two early count sliders. But now he finds himself in a situation where he's going to have to come fastball.
Runner at second here with one man out. Too tight with that one. 3-0. Strike taken up in the zone. In the air now out to left field. Stokes is going to get there as he backs up to put it away, and there are two gone now.
The pitcher, number 41, Carson Fulmer.
Chris Oakey will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher. And now the first pitch. Ready. Here's the 1-0. A ball and a strike. I think it's safe to say he wasn't ready for the fastball.
Wow, was he behind that fastball? Great job on the mound using the curveball to set up the heater.
And they could go either way now, I suppose. A ball and two strikes now. Two out here and a runner at second. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. Here's the 1-2. Now a curveball in there. Strike three called, and the inning is over. Bart Warren has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth. All set for the start of the inning, and standing in is the power hitting second baseman, Keston Hiura.
Keston Hiura.
Now here's the first offering. The fastball here is he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0. As we near the end of this one, it's clear the long ball has played a big role in today's outcome. Dan, D-Row, what are your final thoughts on what we've seen?
Yeah, just non-competitive pitches in some big situations, Dan, and the offense took full advantage.
Yeah, you know, D-Row, one of the things about pitching is you want to have location, and it was obvious in this one today that the pitchers weren't on point, and what happens when that happens? Hitters make you pay, and the long ball was a big part of this one here.
The 2-1 home waves and misses for strike number two.
Hey, I know he's aware he can't tie the game with one swing of the bat, but maybe he's just trying to excite the boys and get one on the board.
The 2-2. Just staying alive, putting together a really good at bat here. The 2-2 one more time.
Pretty easy pitch to lay off there, 2-2. Not even close to being in the strike zone. He made it easy for the hitter in that one.
Fouled away. Another payoff pitch. And he'll finally just wear him down as this one swung on and missed for the first out.
The batter.
Next, the right it'll be Corey Ray, singled last time Ray. Up. From the stretch, a ball and no strikes. Warren rarely finds himself in much trouble out of the bullpen, at least in terms of giving up base hits. He's proven to be a tough guy to barrel up. And it looked like the fastball got away from him there. Action in the bullpen now as a right-hander begins to throw out there. High and away, not close. 3-0. Number 12 waits on deck. One out, nobody on. And there's a strike as he'll try to work his way back. It's 3-1. Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Waiting on it is Smith. Two down.
Now batting. Number 12.
So next to bat will be number 12. Third trip to the plate for him here tonight. 0-2 at this point. First offering on its way. In there, and it's 0-1. Line toward the gap in left center. And this is into the alley and ought to be good for extra bases. And he will pull into second with a two-out double.
This game might be over for all intents and purposes, but somebody forgot to tell this guy. He's a grinder, and he's going to approach every at-bat like it's his last. Does it again here and delivers a double into the gap.
Number 33 will look to provide a little two-out thunder off the bench as he'll hit with a runner at second and two away. He's set and the pitch. One, here's the pitch. Now a breaking ball runs in on him as he's got to get his hands out of the way on that pitch. The 1-1 home is a fastball that misses. In the air down the line and left. On the run is Smith, and it's a foul ball. A bouncer to the left side, and nothing will come of the two-out double as the inning is over. So they can't make anything out of the two-out double. More baseball on the show right after this. She's coming. If I want to keep my life, baby, she'll want it. John Curtis comes on to pitch now, hoping for better results than the other arms that they've run out there in this one. So the batting order turns over now and set to go. Nick Senzel. He comes in with a couple of hits, including a triple in four at-bats. First pitch of the AB now. And he gets ahead here with the fastball, strike one.
He'll take that first pitch strike all day long. If they're going to take 0-0, he's going to pound that zone and get ahead. Much more susceptible down 0-1 than 1-0.
Barely able to make contact. Down 0-2 now. Hit out towards second. Reined in. And there's one away.
Now batting. Number 28.
Digging in, the switch hitter, number 28. He'll hit from the left side of the plate in this matchup. From the stretch, here's the pitch. Now a fastball, a bit too low here. It's ball one. Right-hander starts to loosen out in the bullpen now. The 1-0 delivery. Weak grounder back to the mound. Throw gets him. Two down.
The first baseman, number 6, Logan.
Next Morrison. To dig in, Logan Morrison. First delivery to him.
Talk about stopping the bleeding right here. This guy has come in and just executed everything he's wanted to against this offense. Nice to settle the boys down. Maybe regroup and we can get the bats going.
The pitch. And it's fouled away.
Yeah, you could tell he was ready for another fastball, but the pitcher went to breaking ball and the hitter just fouls that one off.
0-2, here it comes. Here is a ground ball now for the shortstop to the right of second. And he'll make that play look easy as the throw is in time to end the inning. Now to bat, Troy Stokes, starting things for his side in the ninth as they face the improbable odds of trying to come back in this one.
Yeah, not a lot of hope for them at this point, but these guys know these bats still count, at least for their own stats. You can't mill in your chances as a professional.
Ready to deal. Here comes the first pitch. Here we go with inning number nine as the first pitch misses for ball one. The set and the 1-0 pitch.
2-0.
Outside with that delivery, and it's 3-0 now.
Ball three to a leadoff hitter that can run. Not the greatest way to start this right here. I think right now you really have to start pouring some pitches into that strike zone.
And this pitch misses here. It's ball four, and they've got a leadoff base runner aboard to start the ninth.
Well, that is definitely not the way to start an inning. One thing to give up a walk, but to do it on four pitches is pretty alarming. He looks a little thrown off right now.
Now to the plate, Mark Mathias. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. First offering on its way. Now a ball ripped into deep center field. And that ball gets down out near the wall and should be extra bases. The runner from first crosses the plate.
Well, this is a lesson for all those pitchers out there. When you allow the leadoff man on base, it always comes back to haunt you. With no outs, I thought they might hold the runner at third, but they send him anyway, and the run scores.
To the plate now, Daniel Vogelbach, as he'll take a look at ball one. Two hits in four attempts to this point. The 1-0.
Ball two.
Well, he's not proving that he can command his breaking ball in the zone right now. And until he does, there's no reason to bite on it.
2-0 count and the pitch. And he fouls this one off. A runner at second, nobody out. Called strike that time, and it's even at 2-2. From the stretch. Got him. And that's the third time we've written a K next to his name in this one. So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Derek Fisher. He grounded out last time up. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes.
1-0.
Now the 1-0. One out and a runner on second base. Look out. Don't want to hit him there. It's full 3-2. Travis Shaw waits on deck. And he struck out again. That's the third time he's gone down on strikes in this one. So stepping in is Travis Shaw. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. He comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch.
Boy, that's one of the toughest pitches to lay off. A hard breaking ball at the back foot. Tough take on a terrific pitch.
The 1-0 home. A swing and a miss, strike one.
That's just too much velocity upstairs to get good wood on it. It's going to have to lower his sights.
The 1-1 home. And this one will be foul back in among the fans.
His heart sank right there when that ball met the bat, but just had him out front just enough to give him another shot at potentially putting him away.
And they come inside with the fastball, but it misses here, and it's back to 2-2. Has them down to their final strike. Here it comes.
For the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
And now those that have stuck it out tonight come to their feet. Swing and a miss on a pitch that tied him up in knots, and the ball game is over.
Well, this game had its moments, but it got out of hand pretty quick. Always nice when you can coast to a 6-run win. Save your closer for another day and let everyone in on the action.
9-3, the final tally here in this one. The Louisville Bats jumped out to an early lead in the first and never looked back. Cionel Pérez pitches well enough to get the W. Josh Lindblom permitted 6 earned runs to come across in the losing effort. So that's a wrap here tonight. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, this is Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Twitter at MLB The Show.
Our final line score. Third for the victorious Bats. 9 runs on 13 hits. No errors. They left 6 men on base. For the Sounds, 3 runs on 7 hits. No errors. They left 11 men on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 26 minutes. Thank you for joining us here tonight. And we remind you to please drive home safely.